We often see this kind of recess in bottle designs. Let's take a look at how we can approach this with root surfaces and trimming. We will begin with a circle sketch. Activate the Surface tab and extrude. If you look at the finished model, the inside surface is actually an offset of the outer cylinder. We will first need to define this region. I have prepared a sketch beforehand. It is a simple sketch with a line and 2 3-point arcs. This sketch does not need to be a closed profile, but it does need to completely cut through the cylinder. For this sketch, I will fillet the two corners in order to improve the smoothness of the root surface that we are going to build later. Let's use this sketch to split the cylinder. In this case, we can use either the split body or split face commands. Let's use split body. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the cylinder as a body to split. For splitting tool, click on the select box and select the sketch. Make sure that the surface tab is still active. Go to Create, Offset, and select this surface body. Adjust the offset. Let's hide the other two surfaces and compare this offset surface with the sketch. Notice that it does not align with the sketch. The offset operation has shifted these two edges. Let's delete the offset and split body features and start over. A better way to do this might be to offset the whole cylinder at the beginning. Again, make sure that the Surface tab is active. Go to Create Offset and make an offset of the whole cylinder. Let's hide the external cylinder. Instead of performing a split body, let's use the sketch to do a trim. Go to Modify, Trim. Select the sketch as the trim tool. Next, we need to select the portion of the surface to remove. That portion becomes red. The resultant body is exactly in line with the sketch. To build these tapered surfaces, we are going to use the root surface command. Make sure that the Surface tab is active. Go to Create, Root. With the Chain Selection option checked, select the outer boundary of the surface body. As we drag on the distance arrow, you can see that this creates a surface that is swept along the outer edge. We can adjust the angle by turning the wheel. Let's review the outer cylinder. We want to make sure to drag this root surface beyond the cylinder to facilitate trimming later. Go to Modify, Trim. First, let's use the newly created root surface as a tool to trim out this opening for the original cylinder. Select the root surface as the trim tool. This makes it turn blue. Next, we shall select the region to remove. This makes it turn red. Let's isolate the cylinder to see the resultant opening created. Next, we need to trim off the excess of the root surface. Begin the trim tool. This time round, select the cylinder as the trim tool and select this surface to remove. Try to rotate the model until the root surface does not overlap with the cylinder in your line of sight before making the selection. Overlapping bodies can often confuse the command. The root surface creates an even angled surface all around the edge. What if we need to have the bottom surface be much more tapered, like so? To do that, we will need to build the root surface in two segments. Let's delete the trim and root surface features and hide the original cylinder. Begin the root surface command. In this case, we shall uncheck chain selection and select only these edges. Basically, we want to select all edges except for the bottom edge and the bottom two fillets. Adjust the distance and angle. Begin the root command again. Select the bottom edge. Ideally, we want the distance here to be the same as the previous root surface. In order for this to be used as a cutting tool, we need to fill up this gap. We can use the Loft command. Go to Create, Loft. Select these two edges as the profiles. For reals, click on the arrow and click on the filleted corner. To achieve a smooth blend to the two root surfaces, change the continuity options for both to tangent and align to surface. For this, we need a hard edge, so leave it as connected. Repeat the same for the other side. Let's begin the trim command. Notice that we are not able to select the root surface as a whole. Since we carried out two root operations and two lofts, we have ended up with four disjointed surface bodies. To join them together, we need to use the stitch command. Go to Modify, Stitch. Select all these surface bodies and stitch them into one single surface body. The green lines indicate where the surface bodies will be sewn together. With this, we can begin trimming. Select the root surface as the tool and remove this region. Begin a second trim operation. Use the cylinder as a trim tool and trim off the excess of the root surface. From here, we can stitch all the surface bodies into one and thicken. Or we can patch up the two ends to form a solid.